Portions of Daniel's body have aged at a dramatic rate. In some areas, the tissue is over 100 years old, yet other sections have been reduced to an almost fetal stage. Frankly, with his amount of cellular chaos, I'm surprised he's still alive. I doubt he'll live more than 24 hours.
The temporal Cold War has become an all-out conflict. Temporal agents. They've been given orders to change history. Each faction is trying to wipe the others out.
Zara Beth, will you show me where the time portal is?
I can't go through the portal again. If I do, I will die. None of us can go back. Our basic cell structure is adjusted to the time we enter. If you go through the portal again, you will die by the time you reach the other side.
I have eaten animal flesh and I've enjoyed it. What is wrong with me?
You're reverting to your ancestors. 5,000 years before you were born!
How long has he been like this?
Several hours, at least.
He came to believe that we reside in one of infinite dimensions. And what holds us here is the constancy of time. Change that, and it would be what he called opening the window to those other dimensions.
Did he anticipate that these experiments might be dangerous?
I believe he's dying. His neurochemistry has been affected, but I don't know how or why. I've never encountered anything like it before.
How long does he have?
Maybe a couple of days.
It's changing again.
I have been on the other side. I have touched another dimension. Part of me is still there. My mind is floating between two places. It is difficult to know which is which.
We opened a crack, a window into another dimension.
The time distortion we felt.
Captain, it must be stopped.
I've got one of the medical wonders of the galaxy dying in my sick bay.
It's there. Not at all like I thought it would be. Different. The only words that fit are too pale because the images are so vibrant.
It's not like anything anyone has ever experienced before.
There is this kind of life. Not like us, not like this.
Doctor?
I'm just beginning to realize how much of the body is held together by its own internal clock.
If the shuttle's from 6 hours into the future, then so is the other Captain Picard.
He was thrown out of time, which caused his body systems to change their rhythms. Now, slowly, as we get closer to the time that he left, his internal body clock is realigning. Apparently, the normal stimulant had the opposite effect. I've never seen anything like this.
You're saying that when our time intersects with the time he left, in that instant, he will function normally.
Some of the indicators are totally depressed. Others are fluctuating wildly.
But this will be the third time you're going to be removed from your time frame. If we do it a fourth, there could be certain side effects.
You might experience sensory aphasia. It affects the cerebral cortex and can lead to temporal psychosis. That would be your fourth jump.
I'm aware of the risks.
She's dead.
We'll have to recruit her again.
Sir, a fourth jump, she could suffer neural damage, even temporal psychosis.
Unless we repair the timeline, she's going to die. We're giving her another chance to save her crew and herself.
Her encephalographic readings are peaking. She's having an episode.
She's in danger of a cerebral hemorrhage.
What the hell?
Amongst the many horrible things we discovered when weaponizing time, temporal travel can make you pretty sick. Turns out our molecules are designed to function in the time in which they're created. Every molecule fights to either go back in time or jump a cosmic divide.